Madame Kundura, qui nous fait la joie et le plaisir d'être avec nous à Bruxelles. La parole est à vous pour 3 minutes.
Merci beaucoup, Madame Chair. I would like to thank the Director General for being here. Thank you so much. And his presentation was very helpful, as we are still trying to understand what the Commission proposals means in practice. It is rather complicated and with many gray zones. You have identified transport and tourism are the sectors hit the hardest by the pandemic, and it's important that the recovery plan has a strong focus on these sectors, not only because they hit the hardest, but because they are very strong accelerators of the growth. And you know very well that transportation is the backbone of the economy, which will not function properly without an effective transport system. Which brings me to my first point regarding the short-term response to the crisis, the need to avoid bankruptcies. I want to stress that we need to avoid bankruptcies across all transports mode to make sure that when the situation regularizes, people and goods will have enough options to move freely, safely, and with affordable prices. Several tools have been announced by the Commission for short-term relief. The new solvency support instrument, REACT-EU, the Stroganoff Invest-EU. My question is, what is your assessment for the liquidity and working capital needs of the sector, and how will it be covered by the recovery plan? Will it be enough? Timing is also of the essence when we talk about solvency. Support is required immediately. Will the support reach those who need it in time to avoid bankruptcies? On the long term, it is clear that the target is the greening and digitalization of transport. We need to make sure the transition will happen in a fair and inclusive way. For some countries, this means stop being passive consumers of innovating products produced elsewhere and become active and equal players in the new economy through innovation and a strong and sustainable industrial base. This recovery plan must become an opportunity, especially for the countries of the South, to develop a competitive green economy, to leave behind the growth model that strengthens economy and social inequalities in the EU. And even though this requires a political commitment at the national level, it is also, I think, your responsibility to push into this direction when you approve the national plans and projects. Thank you so much.